right. Any further comments from the public? Yeah, you can check in the hallway, please. All right. As Mr. Burris stated a few things, I feel compelled to respond to those. And I think the mayors have spoken well as far as the involvement. So let me just take you for a quick timeline back in history to July of 2019. In July of 2019, multiple casino vendors came to Pope County in hopes of being selected as a vendor and receiving support from myself for the Quorum Court. These vendors presented package after package. They sought to, the common phrase is, one-up one another. And these packages grew. So to say that I nor all these other individuals entertained multiple vendors is an understatement. In fact, when the final packages were derived in July of 2019, if you will recall, I made a public announcement that they would be on public display in this courtroom for the month of July 2019. They remained on public display for the month of July 2019, in which time the public came in and provided me comment as to what they would like to see in a casino resort. From those public comments came the addition of a water park, a convention center for the city of Russellville, the concert venue. Those amenities were added pursuant to public comment after all five packages laid on that desk for the month of July 2019. In the ending weeks of 2019, of July and the 1st of August 2019, it became apparent from our legal representation that we were going to fail at having a local constitutionally, in our minds, election. We had hired law firms to represent us in that defense that had failed to get the county out of litigation. There was one method forward, and that was to choose an applicant, choose a vendor that would provide a product, that would stand behind that product, and would intend to bring to fruition what they promised. Based on those conversations, yes, many justices were involved. When you look at this EDA, I don't know how more transparent you can get when you have every school district, every volunteer fire department, every city, every chamber of commerce, every public education foundation, and every nonprofit. That means I went to all these folks. I didn't somehow pull them out of thin air. I went to everybody listed. So I don't know how more transparent you can get when they're all listed in the EDA. And I don't know how you can assert with any degree of certainty that there was behind closed doors meetings. As to presenting packages, everybody presented packages. The folks from Iowa presented a very nice package. Gulfside presented a package. Justice Skelton, we're sitting in this room, and I, when Mr. Green came in and offered an economic development package, everybody offered an economic development package up front except for the Choctaw. And I believe that was validated by what former Justice Brown just said. So I didn't go out and beg these people to come to Pope County. They came to us. They presented programs. They presented packages. And one stood out superior. So I think we need to take a little history lesson here to remember what got us here to this point today. By no fruition of our own, there were decisions that had to be made. I had a fiduciary duty to look out for the best financial interests of this county. I have done so. I stand by it. And I, you know, those are the decisions that were made in times. Otherwise, I mean, it's a foregone conclusion that we would have an operator given to us by the state of Arkansas by default long before this point, had there not been another vendor withstanding that went to the Supreme Court of Arkansas. So that's a little history lesson that I think is worth retelling, because I think it gets mixed as to somehow Judge Cross ran as an anti-casino candidate. No, folks, I was elected in the primary of May 2018. It had not been approved for the ballot in the state of Arkansas at that time. I swore to uphold a constitutional office. I have done so. I will continue to do so. And I will back our chosen vendor in their pursuit to install, like I said, an economic development agreement that benefits everybody. Benefits everybody in this county. So, Justice Sloan.
I just want to make one comment. I was approached, it was probably nearly 2 months ago now, about a letter of support for a different vendor. And there were two that were being considered at the time. Justice Reeves brought the one from Gulfside. Was that 2 months ago or one?
I don't know.
It doesn't matter. Anyway, long story short, Gulfside, when they came back and asked for that letter, they came forward with an agreement, right, with an offer. When I was approached by Mr. Burris about whether the court would consider a letter of support for Choctaw, I asked what they had to offer us. I asked specifically if they were offering an EDA or what they were bringing to the table that would make me consider doing something like that, right? And I was told if we issued a letter of support, they would negotiate an EDA. So I'd like to support what you just said, because that's putting the cart before the horse. I mean, we're not, that's stupid. So I just wanted to say that publicly, that this process has been difficult, been a very strong learning curve, but I do not, I think Judge Cross is speaking truthfully here.
Good job.
Okay, good. Justice Reed.
I like what Will Wetzel had to say. You know, this has been a battle, and it's torn communities apart. It's torn families apart. I think it is time for us to come together, and let's move this forward and quit making Polk County a laughingstock of the state. Let's take advantage of what we got, and let's go forward together.
Ladies and gentlemen, again, thank you for your attendance. I would entertain a motion to adjourn. Have a second.
Second.
Andy, all in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Call the meeting adjourned at 6:33 p.m.